In Liberia, community farm on the land. So they are engaged in different farming activities. In Liberia, local community produce rice, locally made rice. They produce edible goods. They get palm from the wild that they can sell as a commodity to get money. They get benefits for hunting because they hunt in the wild and they get that. But much more importantly is they use the forest as a source of protecting and healing. So it's a medicinal line. They get the medicinal plants from the forest as well. So a whole range of different benefits they get. They are particularly used in NTFPs right now, timber forest products, and to get to the local market that brings them income. The idea, if you do the comparison between what they get from the wild and what the oil palm will produce in a short period of time, they think that the wild is much more productive than what the oil palm will produce. For example, you can have a village here of up to maybe 30 houses, and that village could have up to maybe 30 houses could have up to maybe 60 to 75 family heads, and each of the family head being a man can produce like a thing of oil every week because they cut the palm in the wild. So if you have each family here producing a tin of oil, which would be, let's say, 60 men, that's 60 tins times 1,500. See the margin that comes to that community every month, every week. If you times that by the month, that's a good sum of money. If that land was given away for oil palm plantation, the income would not come directly to that community. They would not get any benefit directly. Few community members will be employed, and that employment is short-term leave because they do not have the skill to get a preferential job with the companies. So some of the jobs they will get will be maybe working on the nurseries, brushing in the palm plantation. But when the palm has grown to a certain level, you don't brush on it anymore. It virtually kills the grass on itself. So then people start dropping off the job. So those are some of the things that the communities are now measuring. So we're doing kind of work in Liberia right now called valuation. It's a module we are doing. So we'll go to the community and say, for example, what are the things you eat here every day? So we eat cassava, we eat edo, we eat plantain. So what are the quantities you eat if you had a family of five persons? Oh, we eat this quantity, we eat that quantity. The quantity you eat if you were selling it, how much would you sell it? We sell it at this price, we sell it at that price. We use that measurement over a period of week, use that over a period of month, use that period of over a year. And then you can see as an average family of five persons, the kind of value they take from the forest. If they were to buy those commodities, the amount they would spend. So we measure that. That's the valuation model we're doing now right now. And that helps the community to understand that, oh, we have a value here. This is much more important than we've thought. And also, those kind of things are the kind of measurement we are using to strengthen community understanding. We are not saying don't engage with the oil palm. But if you do the measurement and you know the differences, then you can make informed decisions. Those are added value to ensuring that people have free pride and informed consent. And based on that, they can make decisions.